Welcome to a new episode of Penis Around the World. Let's have a look at penis size in Argentina. A new study measured 800 Argentinian men with a mean age of 54.2 years and correlated penile length to height, weight, and foot length. So much I can reveal up front. Mean height was 174 centimeters, which is 5 feet 7. Standard deviation was 6.9 centimeters, which is 2.7 inches. 174 centimeters is not very tall, so it will be interesting to know more about their penile dimensions. If you are not familiar with UroChannel and or Penis Around the World, check out the playlist at the end. In this series, I'm searching the scientific literature for anthropometric measurements of the penis in different countries. Very important, these are not my measurements. I am just the messenger. So you women out there, there is no need to write angry comments that I should leave your country and stop measuring your men. All of that has been done already by your fellow countrymen. In Argentina, measurements were taken in four different hospitals across different regions of the country. They used a standardized approach measuring length at the upper side of the penis using a measuring tape. The tape was firmly pressed against the pubic bone to eliminate any reading errors from the pubic fat pad. The foreskin was retracted and the tip of the glands taken as a point of reference. For girth, they measured around the base of the penis. Measurement methods vary across the literature, so one always has to keep in mind that measurement results may differ between studies just because of methodology. In some studies, they use a rigid ruler. In some studies, they measure girth at the midshaft. All measurements were taken in anesthesia because these were men who came in for all kinds of surgical procedures other than for penile issues. So they measured flaccid penises, which they then stretched to obtain an estimate of the erect length. I have already pointed out that there are some downsides with stretched measurements. However, with the right amount of force, stretched measurements correlate well to erectile length. Since the measurements were taken under anesthesia, the researchers think that they were able to apply enough traction. There was also a statistically significant correlation between flaccid and stretched measurements, reflecting a reliable method. They decided against injecting erection-inducing agents. If the dose was too low, the erection would not reach its maximum and it would be unreliable. Furthermore, if the dose was too high, one would have to interfere to bring the erection down again. I would say that's fair, given the circumstances of surgery where time is of the essence once the patient is under anesthesia. So there are no measurements of the erect stage. Flaccid length was 11.4 centimeters on average with a standard deviation of 2 centimeters. I am giving you the translated numbers in inches in brackets below, by the way. Stretched penile length was 15.2 centimeters on average with a standard deviation of 2.2 centimeters. And girth was 10.1 centimeters on average with a standard deviation of 1.3 centimeters. This means that Argentinian men seem to range slightly above global average published in several studies. In a review consisting of over 15,000 men, average flaccid length was 9.16 centimeters and stretched 13.24 centimeters. Mean girth was 9.31 centimeters. So Argentinian men come quite close to 6 inches on average, but if you just look at the distribution from the article, out of 800 men, only 4 or 5 actually have stretched lengths between 21 to 22 centimeters, which equals 8.2 to 8.7 inches. If you look at the comment section of my most popular video of all time, surprisingly many guys commenting here claim to have penis sizes of at least 8 inches or regard 8 inches as small. This is the perfect example why self-reported measurements are tricky, because most men would add a few inches if given the chance. Penile size is normally distributed across the population. If you've never heard about normal distribution, standard deviation, and so on, I'm about to give you a summary, so keep watching. By the way, what about correlations to foot length, weight, and height? There wasn't any. So how could you tell someone might be well endowed? Look at his digit ratio. Recently, I uploaded a video about it, but for some reason, it is not well received. People don't seem to understand the message. I get many negative comments, but folks, this is real science. However, correlations may be tricky, so make sure to watch the video until the end for my analysis. Here's the link. And now some statistical explanations. In population-based studies, we commonly assume that physical features are distributed throughout the population in a certain pattern. Most values gather around the average value, but also extreme features exist. There is such a thing as micropenis, and also gigantic monsters of a penis, which make wearing pants very uncomfortable sometimes. The standard deviation tells us how dispersed the data is in relation to the mean value. Within one standard deviation above and below the average, 68.3% of all data are gathered. Within two standard deviations above and below, you will find 95.4% of all values. The median is a kind of average which is more robust to extreme values which would bring the average up or down. The median is the middle of the recorded values. Let's do an example. You have three values, 2, 4, and 15. For the average, you add them up and divide them by 3. The average is 21 divided by 3, which equals 7. For the median, you put your numbers in a consecutive order and pick the middle, which is 4. As you can see, the median compensates for extreme values in the measured data and is closer to the real picture. Here's the link to Penis Around the World. Stay curious. Maybe I'm going to visit your country next time. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.